Hello and welcome to my another learning session about pattern flyweight. Who am I? Let me introduce myself. My name is Alexander. I am a freelancer from Germany. Here you have my contact information if you're interested in working with me. What kind of services I provide to my clients? Software development, creating automating unit tests, doing requirements engineering for my clients, advising of companies, helping companies to find suitable candidates for permanent developer positions in Germany. So if you're interested, here you go, here you have my contact information. Now let's talk about the design pattern flyweight. So basically flyweight is a pretty nice pattern. So what is the purpose of the flyweight pattern? The book itself, which I should introduce you, had first design patterns from where I got the idea. Kind of not an advertisement, but rather kind of referencing of it. So they define flyweight pattern as it use one instance of a class to have ability to manage many virtual instances. And the example which the book presented was about the case. In one case, and basically this is an initial case, you have a lot of trees, many of trees, which you create in your project. And at some point it becomes kind of a failure because user generates way too many trees, and then it produces loss of memory. It goes beyond memory and crash. And here we have a pattern which is flyweight pattern, which say you can have one instance for managing of state of very many different other states which you can create. So this you can imagine, instead of creating many trees, you have one large big tree which have this branches, and on the each branch you have a tree. And if the tree is not needed, sorry for my drawing abilities, but if the tree not needed, it deleted. But you have, instead of many objects, you have only one object, and this is a flyweight pattern, so to speak. Let me show you the UML diagram which book have to provide actually, but this is what my understanding is. The example is as follows: you have an interface with a contract for tree, and then you have two classes which implement the contract from the interface, and then you have factory which actually responsible for creating these trees. So let me do that as example. So I have here tree factory, and as you see, tree factory creates two trees, and it provides a method get tree to get particular type of tree. So now this is an implementation of conifer tree, and then you have the test. First of all, I'm testing if I can create such objects. But here is actual example of the flyweight. First, here you see the numbers, they are position of the tree. So this I cannot speak. Deciduous location. So this type of tree is an array, two-dimensional array. It have coordinates for each of the tree, and then another type of tree and another locations of the tree. And here I doing, I think this is a catching the exception if exception will happen. The code is provided by the book, so this is how it goes. So I need to, of course, get hold of a tree, which an object, as I said earlier, for the D and C. And D is deciduous trees and C conified tree. And when I got the instance of each of particular type of tree, I need to iterate over the array and just populate. Actually, I'm populating the display, and display then probably will output the tree at the locations. Yeah, things like that. And then the same happens to the conified locations. And if something happens during this population of the trees, I don't know if a tree already somehow was put it, then I probably catch an exception. But let's run it. So you have 1, 2, 3 tree of type deciduous tree, and then three types of tree of conifer, another one. So I have 6 types of tree, but I only, when you look the factory method, I only create the tree only one time. So I have actually 2 instances, but I'm representing a lot of more. So I try to refactor myself right now. So I creating 2 types of tree, but in reality, when you run the test, I can assign even, I don't know, 100 type of trees, location of 100 of types of trees. And then when I run it, I actually have different type of trees provided by the location. And I hope you understood the meaning of the flyweight pattern. So basically, let's go back to the drawing board. Instead of creating many instances of a trees, I can use flyweight pattern, which allow me to create only fewer amount of instances, but with a few numbers of the instances, I can actually present a lot of numbers of instances. So basically, I don't know, this is the screen. I have my trees represented on the screen. But actually, from the state, I have only one type of one type class type and another class of other type. So I have 2 different objects types. And this is the power of the flyweight pattern. So what are the drawback of the flyweight pattern? Well, you have single logical instances of the class, and they would not behave independently from the other instances. So basically, if one tree goes once in one movement, then other tree of the same type will go to the direction. So you need to have clear separation of behavior, and I don't know, maybe it can be useful in actual game, computer games, where you have kind of background information which you want to represent, and you know that it's behaving not so important, so the behavior always actually not know representing of what are, oh, I mean, some of the objects which have pretty one in the same behavior, and you can use that pattern to represent this behavior. So you create less instances, but it allow you to manage actually even more objects, not the objects but the states. you represent many states by creating less objects. And this is a flyweight pattern. And the book itself, Head First Design Pattern, says the flyweight is used when a class has many instances and they can all be controlled identically. And this is, I think, the core of the design pattern. In the production, Java Enterprise, I don't think that I saw that, but I think this is actually a pattern which can be used in the games, Unreal or Unity 3D, depending on what kind of engine you try to use, but it's pretty clever design pattern. And as always, with each of the design pattern, you should always have common sense. If you don't have identical behavior of your many instances, they don't use this pattern. Use this pattern only if you have many instances which have identical behavior. Only then you will get real advantages of using this pattern. And that's it. Another interesting pattern. And I will see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.